During the Prime Minister's interaction with electorates on implementation of government programs, leaders noted that some beneficiaries have started accessing the Parish Development Model Funds. However, they reported that the funds received are less by 50,000 shillings, yet the government promised 1 million shillings per individual household.
People received less money than what was promised. We were told we would get 1 million shillings, but instead, people were getting 950,000 shillings, which is less.
Nabanja assured beneficiaries that the government meets all charges and no money should be deducted from the 1 million shillings. However, she challenged beneficiaries to value the funds.
We beg you to use the money wisely. Use it for development purposes.
I started working and people have bought their inputs and they have planted this season. So I want to thank the district authority, the Minister of Finance, the President of the Republic of Uganda for PDM. PDM will succeed.
Currently, some beneficiaries in Kakumiro have benefited, with at least each parish having 33 people receiving the Parish Development Model Funds.
I want to assure you Ugandans that here in Kakumiro district, particularly Narweyo, Nyarweyo and Ektayuka, we have received that fund. And our residents, our people have already benefited. I want to inform you that in our parishes, at least in each parish, 33 million have already reached, and at least 33 people have already received that money and they are using it very well.
30 homes received 30 million shillings for the PDM, which means each house received 1 million shillings. People have used this money for their projects.
While addressing residents at Kigjwenje, Kiriamasasa, Kirira, Ndongo and Buruko trading centers, Nabanja was briefed on a number of issues affecting residents ranging from land grabbing, poor roads and water scarcity, among others.
We are also facing issues of land grabbings here. For example, one of the tycoons here got a land title covering an area with over 600 houses, yet it was only supposed to be just 1 acre he had paid for. So now, he has a title for an estimated 132 acres. We request you to intervene so people can live here peacefully. Land wrangles are giving us sleepless nights, yet we've been on this land for over 30 years.
The Prime Minister assured residents of cancellation of fraudulent land titles. Nabanja promised to engage the Lands Minister, Judith Nabakoba, on the land concerns.
The bona fide occupants are supposed to be given priority in any land transaction. If that fails, we are going to send Lands Minister Judith Nabakoba to help settle this matter.
Nabanja assured residents of road rehabilitation and construction in the next financial year. Story by Ismail Kasoha for the news.